Here again, I'll say what I said before. Every now and then, just like, remember someone who may have seen the movie, Godfather Again, there was a character named Pete Clemenza who was teaching Michael how to shoot a revolver in the basement. And they were doing target practice, and he was telling them how to pull the trigger and all like that. And then he went on to tell about what this was really all about. He said, you know, we all work together. I mean, you know, the different families, the crime families here in New York City. He said, but every now and then, you know, it's a lot of bad blood. He said, every 10, 15 years, see, we have to clean out the bad blood, because, which means that somebody becomes disgruntled about they're not getting their cut. Now, it's the same way with the racist system. Every now and then, the white supremacists become disgusted with each other. They don't like the way the business is being run. Well, lots of people say, you know, lots of people that believe in white supremacy said that, you all, I mean, you know, you're white just like me, but you're going to have this black president, you know, a black person being president named Obama, because the only way that President Barack Obama could have become President Barack Obama is that a lot of white people voted for President Barack Obama. Now, a lot of other white people said, well, you're going to set some type of precedent that we're not going to be able to live down if you do that. So you don't ever want to have a black president. Not ever. I mean, you rig the election or do whatever. And other white people say, well, look, you had a president of South Africa named Nelson Mandela. All right. This is the wave of the future. We're going to have quite a few black people with name recognition and with fancy titles. Said, but the key is, don't give them any power. Don't let them do anything. Let them strut around, make fancy speeches. I have a lot of photo ops, get the picture taken, spread the picture all over the walls everywhere. I mean, make all of the black people think that they got some power because they got a black president or a black queen or a black king or whatever. And, you know, give them lots of publicity, lots of creature comforts, make them real comfortable, and use them to showcase, all right? Because that's the wave of the future. We're going to have a lot of showcase black people. But the majority of black people are going to keep suffering like they always have. Keep them that way. Now, the other viewpoint of the same bunch of white people who are practicing white supremacy, not talking about all white people, but talking about the two factions in the gangster operation, who are the smartest and most powerful, by the way. But they have these arguments with each other. They say, no, you can't set that example, because it'll be, next thing you know, you'll have too many of them wanting to be somebody. We got a lot of them now that never want to be anybody. They just want to be dead by the time they're 18, and they join little gangs and whatnot so they can kill each other off because they don't even want to be here. Keep them that way, all right? And they say, well, yeah, that'll work for a while, but we're thinking 100 years down the road. We're thinking 1,000 years down the road. We got to have a lot of showcase black people up front. Just enough to fool the rest of them into thinking that they have power that they don't have. So it's like Clemenza telling young Michael, every now and then, you know, we got to have a war among ourselves. You know, and whomever comes out, I mean, that's the way our gangster operation is going to work. But every now and then, we're going to have these disagreements, and we're going to kill each other. But we can't let it go on too long, because just like some of the callers in the program were saying, hey, this thing will become unraveled altogether, and won't nobody be in business, all right? So, you know, we'll have this little war, you know, and it'll go on for a few weeks or a few months. Maybe a couple of years, but eventually we'll all come to the table like they always do, just like in the movie The Godfather. Don Corleone said, Well, Santine is dead. They killed him out there on the causeway. That's my son, who was running most of the operations. You know, he's the guy who knows the streets and all like that. He's dead now, so this war ends. This conflict we are having right now ends. Let's come to the table. Let's call all the Tattaglias and the Barzinas and all the heads of the families from Kansas City, and we're going to talk about how we're going to handle these black people up in Harlem, all right? But we're going to do it around the table. We're not going to do it out in the streets with this gunfire. It's bad for business.
Mm-hmm.
We can't keep on like this.
Okay.
That's all it is. Look at that movie, Godfather 1, and you got it all right there.